Hello everyone, myself Mr. Sandeep, and you are learning mathematics here at my YouTube channel. So this video is specially for class 12th, and in this video we are going to discuss about chapter number 1, that is relations and functions. In our last video we have discussed about the basics of the relations, that is what do you mean by the relation, what is domain, what is codomain, and what is the range, and how to prove a relation as reflexive, as symmetric, or transitive. I hope that you have understood the basics, and on the basis of that previous knowledge, we must be able to solve our first exercise, that is exercise 1.1. Right? So question number 1 is very easy, on that is totally based on the that basic knowledge that we have provided in the first video. And in this video we would like to start discuss the question from question number 2. Okay, so to save your time, I have solved the questions in advance, so only the thing is left, that is the discussion with you people only. Okay, and I hope you have tried to solve the exercise 1.1, and today I am going to help you out in the solution of exercise 1.1. So let's start with question number 2. So you are given with, you can have a look on the question also, show that the relation R in the set R of real numbers. So what is the set here? The real numbers defined as, what do you mean by real numbers? In which all numbers are coming, including integers as well as fraction also. As you know, between two integers 1 and 2, there are infinite number of rational numbers. Okay, there are so many decimals also. So real numbers are covering all the numbers. Defined as R is equal to AB such that A is less than equal to B square is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. Okay, that is also a simple question. Only a hint is required that how to solve this. So let's move towards the discussion for this question. So like this, you have to write down in the starting, A is equal to, let A is the set that is equal to real numbers, then R, that is a relation AB such that A is less than equal to B square. So these two things are given to you, and we have to prove reflexive first of all. So for R is reflexive, the given relation will be reflexive if, first of all beta, always write down the condition in the starting, so it will definitely help you in the solution. So if and only if AA belongs to R, for all A, this is the value of A belongs to A. So these value must be taken from this set A. Okay, you cannot take any other value except this set. So let us, for solving this question, let us suppose A is equal to 1/2. So yahan pe, in place of A and B, you have to take the same value, that is equal to 1/2. You can take other values also, but particularly for solving this question, we are taking 1/2, for example, right? So if you put here A is equal to 1/2 and B also equal to 1/2, so what the result you are getting? 1/2 is less than 1/4. Just forget about this is equal to sign. Half is less than 1/4. Is it true? No, which is not true. It means R is not reflexive. Clear? So beshak aapke paas aur number ho jis pe ye reflexive prove ho jaye, but at least agar aapka ek number bhi aisa nikal aaye jis pe ye reflexive na prove hota ho, it means the whole relation is not reflexive. Clear? Then come to the second part, that is symmetric. How to prove it symmetric? So R is symmetric if AB belongs to R and BA also belongs to R. अगर आपका ए बी आर को बिलोंग करता है, देन बी ए शुड बिलोंग्स टू आर. सो दिस इज द लैंग्वेज हियर. सो लेट अस टेक फॉर दिस, ए इज इक्वल टू -1 एंड बी इज इक्वल टू 2. लेट अस ट्राई टू पुट हियर इन द रिलेशन, ए इज इक्वल टू -1, बी इज इक्वल टू 2 हियर इन द गिवन रिलेशन. सो -1 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 2 स्क्वायर, 2 स्क्वायर इज व्हाट? 4. और नाउ सी, -1 इज लेस देन 4, -1 इज लेस देन 4, इट इज लेस देन 4 बट नॉट इज इक्वल टू 4. But just forget about this is equal to sign, we have to concentrate on this sign only. Okay, so -1 is less than 4, yes, it means these values belongs to real, but अगर इसका आप रेसिप्रोक मतलब रिवर्स करते हो, इफ यू टेक ए इज इक्वल टू टू एंड बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन, देन व्हाट इट गोइंग्स टू प्रूव, टू इज लेस देन इक्वल टू वन, लिविंग जस्ट लीव द इज इक्वल टू साइन, टू इज लेस देन वन, नो, टू इज नेवर लेस देन वन, इट डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू द रियल नंबर, ओके, इट डज नॉट बिलोंग टू द रिलेशन, सो दिस डू नॉट सपोर्ट द गिवन रिलेशन, क्लियर, सो इट इज नॉट सिमेट्रिक. After that, let's move for the transitive. For this kind of question, you have to keep one thing in your mind that numerical value of this, जो आपका बड़े वाला है, उसका आपने numerical value you have to keep bigger always. Okay, just to forget about the sign, but the numerical value of B should be taken as greater. After that, come to the transitivity. Now, ट्रांजिस्टिव प्रूव करने के लिए क्या है, इफ ए बी बिलोंग्स टू आर एंड बी सी बिलोंग्स टू आर, ओके, देन ए सी लिविंग बिहाइंड दिस बी सेंटर वन, ए सी शुड बिलोंग्स टू आर, सो फॉर दिस यू कैन टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू थ्री, बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस फोर, सी इज इक्वल टू वन, लेट अस सपोज फ्रॉम आर साइड, सो इफ यू आर टेकिंग ए बी फॉर दिस वन, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू प्रूव वट, फोर स्केयर दैट इज 16 इज लेस देन 3, यस. After that, take this minus 4 and 1. You will prove here minus 4 is less than 1 square. Yes. After that, 1 and this 3 and 1. How is this? 3 is less than equal to 1. Is it okay or not? No. This is not supporting our given relation. That is A is less than B square. This is not possible at all. So therefore, R is not transitive. If this is true, this is true, this must be true. For transitive, but this is false, so therefore the given relation is not transitive. So we have proved our question, the given relation is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. Is it clear? I hope you have understood. So without wasting time, let's move to our question number 3, that is also same, so let us discuss about it. So the question statement is, check whether the relation R, so what is the relation here, R defined in the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The given set is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As R is equal to AB such that B is equal to A plus 1. These all things are given in the, these two things are given to you in the question only. Clear? From there we have written. Now what is the meaning of this? If you take A is equal to 1 here, then what you will get the value of B? 1 plus 1, 2. Then put A is equal to 2, you will get B is equal to 3. Similarly, for 3, you will get B is equal to 4. For 4, you will get B is equal to 5. Then 5, 6. So here I have written one more value and after that I have crossed here. This is to show you that by mistake, if you are taking here 6, the value of A, then you are getting the value of B is equal to 7. But you must know that this value of 7 should be there in A. Clear? While discussing the basics, we have discussed that all these values of x and y, so this is x and y, xy, xy, they must belong to the set A. But this value of y, that is 7, it does not belong to A. That's why you cannot take the value of x is equal to 6 here. Okay? So that's why we are stopping our set up to here only. Clear? Then let's start the reflexivity. For reflexivity, you know 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6 should belongs to R. Okay, now see, is it there? No, 1, 1 is not there, 2, 2 is not there, 3, 3 is not there, 4, 4 is not there. No such that elements are there. So it doesn't belong to the relation. So therefore, it is not reflexive. Okay, then come to the symmetric. If 1, 2, you can see 1, 2, one of the element of the set, okay, that belongs to R, it means 2, 1 should be there somewhere. Now see, 2, 1 is there? No, it is not there. But 2, 1 does not belongs to R. So this is the way how to write down in the fair copy or in your exam. So it means R is not symmetric. Clear? Very easy this topic is. Then come to the transitive part. Transitive, here 1, 2 belongs to R. You can see here 1, 2 belongs to R. After that, it should next one should be starting from this 2. Okay, So this is also discussed in our basic 1, 2, 2, 3. It can be 2, 5. Okay, but जहाँ से ये end होता है वहीं से ये start होना चाहिए. 1, 2 belongs to R, just see, it is there, yes. Then 2, 3 belongs to R, yes, it is there. Then it means for transitive 1, 3 should be there. Just see, 1, 3 is there, but 1, 3 does not belongs to the relation. So therefore, the given R, I have written in short, therefore R is not transitive. So that is your answer, clear? So let's move to question number 4. Show that the relation R, so this is the given relation R, AB such that A is less than equal to B, just like your question number 2, is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. Okay, reflexive we have to prove, after that we have to prove it as a transitive also, but symmetric will not be there, clear? So straight away they have given in the statement of the question. So now the given relation is AB such that A is less than B. For reflexivity, AA should be there. Now you take, if you take here AA in place of A and B, both values are same, both are AA and both belongs to the given set, that is A. So here A is less than equal to A, right? Are you getting this or not? In place of A and B, we have written A and A both same. So it means AA belongs to relation R. So therefore R is a reflexive. Clear? Then come to the symmetric part. R is symmetric. The given relation is symmetric. If AB belongs to R, then BA must belongs to R. Okay? For solving this, let us take one example, that is of 1, 2. Okay? 1, 2. If you are taking 1 is less than 2. 1 is less than 2, that is true, but 2, 1 does not belong to R. That should not happen here. Yahan pe ye false ho jayega, theek hai? Because according to the relation, the first number should be less than the second one, but here 2 is not less than equal to 1. So therefore, R is not symmetric. Clear? Then come to the transitive. AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R. It means A and C should belong to R. This is the rule for the transitivity. Now, A is less than equal to B and B is less than equal to C. Okay, it implies, now see, A B se chota hai, B C se chota hai. Try to feel this. A is less than B and further B is less than C. Then it implies A will be definitely less than C. Okay, so therefore R is transitive. So you can take as a simple example for this, if you have not understood. Suppose, let's talk about the three numbers, 1, 2 and 3. 1 is less than 2 and further 2 is less than 3. You can take here any number. In place of 3, you can take 7 also. Clear? But that should be less than 2. Okay? But these two numbers should be same. That is the condition only. 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3. It means 1 is less than 3. Clear? Why we have taken this simple example? Because you very well known about the simple numbers. Aapko pata hai ki 3 1 se bada hai. 1 3 se chota hai. So for making you to understand this condition, we have taken this example. Otherwise, no need to discuss in the exam time. That is your choice. If you want to show, then it's okay. Okay. Then come to your question number 5. I have written here same as question number 2. So no need to waste the time here in discussion. That is exactly in as your question number 2. You can see in place of there we have discussed A is less than equal to B square. In this question it is A is less than equal to B cube, or there is nothing no difference in this question and question number 2. Then come to your question number 6. Show that the relation R in the set 1, 2, 3. So what is the given set here? 1, 2, 3. So let us give the name as A. Given by R is equal to 1, 2, 2, 1. Symmetric but not, neither reflexive nor transitive. ठीक है जी, हमने symmetric prove करना है. So let's start with this. For reflexive. For reflexive, AA should belongs to R. AA मतलब 1, 1 should be there. It is there? No. 2, 2 is there? No. Here 1, 1, 1, 2, 2 do not belongs to R. Therefore, R is not reflexive. Very simple. Then symmetric. If AB belongs to R, then BA should belongs to R. For example, if 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 should be there. It is there. Yes. So it means this is symmetric. Okay. Then come to the transitive. For proving it as transitive, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, then AC should belongs to R. Right. So AB, what is AB? 1, 2. BC is what? That is 2, 1. And 1, 1 is should be there. Now see, 1, 1 is should belongs to R. Check it out here. It is there or not? No, it is not there. It means, but 1, 1 does not belongs to the given relation R. So therefore, R is not transitive. Clear? So very simple solution for this question number 6. All parts are, I think all questions are similar to each other. Only you need to do the practice for that. Okay? Once you have go through the solutions, and after that you have to try yourself. Clear? Then come to your question number 7. Show that the relation R in the set A of all the books in the library of the college. So what is your given set A? That is set of all the books in the library. You know, so many books are there in the library, right? So it may be possible out of all that 1000 books, 100 can be having same number of pages. Okay, 100 can be, I am not saying they will be, they can have same number of pages. Some probability is there. Okay, so after that, XY, such that X and Y have same number of pages. So what is the relation between two books that both are have same number of pages? So this is the given relation in this question, is an equivalence relation. So we have to prove this relation is equivalence relation. Now beta, we have discussed in the basics. So again, I am repeating, if you need to prove any relation as equivalence relation, then first of all, you need to prove it as a reflexive, then transitive, then after that symmetric. Okay. If a given relation is reflexive, symmetric, as well as transitive, then that relation will be equivalence relation. Okay, so let us start. A comma A should belongs to R. For a relation to be reflexive, AA should belongs to R. It means XY ki jagah kya aayega aapka? Both here XX should belongs to R. For all X belongings to A, kehta hai X and X have same number of pages. Can you say this? X and X, ek hi book agar do bar dekhi jaye. If you see, otherwise, suppose if there are two copies of NCERT books of class 12 in your school library, then is it possible that both books will be having different number of pages? No. Okay, of same edition. Okay, so they will be having same number of pages. Huh? If you are talking about the NCERT books of class 11 and 12, then they are the different books. X and Y will be different. So they may have different pages also, number of pages. But here we are talking about class 12 book only. It means that is first book is X, second book is also X. And definitely they will have the same number of pages. So this is nothing from the, I think, from the mathematics. This is from your common sense only. Okay. It means, it implies R is reflexive. Clear? Then let's move to the symmetric part. He's saying if AB belongs to R, then BA should belongs to R. Clear? Now see, XY. XY belongs to R and YX should belongs to R. So this is the condition. AB ki jagah, just we are replacing XY only. Now see, X. Now we are saying that NCERT book of class 12 have same number of pages as that of class 11th. ठीक है, दूसरा बंदा बोल रहा है कि class 11th और class 12th का same number of pages है, so both are the same thing or not? ठीक है, or you can say any simple example, X is the brother of Y. Can you say Y is the brother of X? If both are boys, condition is both are boys. X is a brother of Y. दूसरा बंदा बोल रहा है कि Y is the brother of X. So this is same. ठीक है, है तो दोनों भाई, relation same है दोनों के बीच में. So books X and Y both have the same number of pages. So therefore, R is symmetric. Clear? After that, transitive. If AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, then AC should belong to R. X, Y, Z. Suppose let us take the example of three books. That is, first book is X, second one is Y, and third one is Z. Now see, what the condition is saying? X and Y both have same number of pages, right? And YZ have same number of pages. Okay, see here, X or Y ka same hai, aage Y ka Z ke saath same hai. It means X or Z ka bhi same hoega. So therefore it implies X and Z have same number of pages. It implies XZ belongs to the given relation R. So therefore R is transitive. Okay, we have proved all the three parts. The given relation, that is reflexive, that is symmetric, that is transitive as it is. So therefore, the given relation R is an equivalence relation. Clear? So maybe you can, there can be some problem in understanding. So what is the method for this? You have to go through the solution 2-3 times. Okay, and try to write down yourself. First of all, read them, prepare them. After that, try to write down. You will be the master of these relations. Then come to your question number 8. So the given set in the textbook is set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Given by relation R is equal to AB such that A minus B is even number is an equivalence relation. So now in this question also we have to prove this relation is equivalence. So let us sum up this question very fast and theory part will remain same as done in the previous question. So see here how I have done this question. Reflexive here. AA belongs to R. If our relation needs to be reflexive, then AA must belong to R. AA means in place of B, you will write down A only. A minus A, that is equal to 0, and 0 is a even number. Okay? We can say 0 is a even number. So you can take other example also because you have to take the values from here. AA means 1, 1 lena hai apne. 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. 3 minus 3, 0. 4 minus 4, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. So all that collection, that elements are satisfying this relation. A minus B is the even number. So therefore, yes, in short, I have written, you have to write down full. Yes, the given relation R is reflexive. Let us check about the symmetric now. If AB language, just listen to the language. If AB belongs to R, then BA should belongs to R. Clear? Now A minus B is equal to what? That is even number, you know. So let us take its reciprocal. So what I am going to do, I will take minus common from here. So started from B minus A. Otherwise you can start from here also. If you will take minus common here, then you will take here, you will be getting here minus of B minus A. Okay, otherwise leave it. Start from here. Now consider B minus A. From B minus A, just take minus common. You will get here A minus B. What is the modulus of this negative? So that will be positive only. Ultimately, what you are getting? Modulus of B minus A is equal to the modulus of A minus B. Both are the same thing. It means if this is even, that must be even number. Okay, so it means reverse is also true. So hence it is symmetric also. Clear? Then come to the third part, that is transitive. Third condition. A minus B is even. Okay, let us see. Let us suppose B minus C is even. Suppose we are talking about three numbers. First number is A, second is B, and third one is C. The difference of first two, that is equal to even, that is given to you. The difference of another two, that is also even. Okay, that is also given to you. Now what we will do, we will add them. This is the method. A minus B plus B minus C will give you what? Now see, this minus B plus B will be cancelled out. A minus C will be left, and that will be equal to even plus even. If you will add two even numbers, you can check yourself. 2 plus 2, 4. 2 plus 6, 8. 2 plus 10, 12. Always the sum of two even numbers will be always the even number. So here we have got A minus C is equal to even number. So you can use modulus also here. No issue. Okay. So it implies AC belongs to R. Clear? So this was the condition: if AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, AC must belongs to R, and that we have proved that AC belongs to R. So therefore, yes, it is transitive. Okay, yes, 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 three conditions are satisfied. Hence we can say the given relation, that is R, this one, AB such that A minus B is even, is equivalence relation. Clear? Now one more part is there for this question. I think I have forgot to discuss over here, that show that all the elements of 1, 3, 5, all the elements of 1, 3, 5, now see 1, 3, 5, they are related to each other. Okay, now see 1 minus 3 minus 2, 3 minus 1 2, 1 minus 5 minus 4, 5 minus 1 4, 3 minus 5 minus 2. So every time when you will take these two numbers out of these three from this given set, you will always get the even number. Clear? It means all the elements of this set, they are related to each other. So like this, normally you have to give the answer. So you will write down here that 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 2, which is even number. 3 minus 5, that is equal to minus 2, which is even number. 1 minus 5 is equal to minus 4, that is also even number. So therefore, all the elements of the given set 1, 3, 5, they are related to each other. So after that, and all the elements of 2, 4, same is for 2, 4. Now see, 2 minus 4, that is minus 2, which is a even number. So there are two elements only here. So both are related to each other. But now try to solve this. 1, first element of this, second of this. 1 minus 2, that is minus 1, which is not the even number. 3 minus 2, 1, that is not the even number. 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3, which is not the even number. So there is no relation between this and this set. They are not related. Okay, I hope you have understood. This is the simple topic here to discuss, only about the even and odd numbers. Clear? Then question number 9 I have written same as that of this question number 8. So after that, beta, I hope that you are now able to solve this exercise 1.1, because rest of the questions, they are same as we have done in the exercise 1.1. Okay, you may go through the examples also, because the next question, they can be based on the examples also. Okay, and this is out of 16, we have discussed 10 questions here. So you must solve rest of the six questions. Out of 6, one is true false only. You have to go through the rules. On the basis of that, you have to give the answer as true or false. Now question number 10, simply I will discuss over here. You have to give an example of a relation, which is, suppose they are saying in the NCERT book, first part is what? It is symmetric, but neither reflexive nor transitive. Okay, so इसमें कोई formula नहीं लगना बेटा, कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि हम बहुत complication follow करते हुए फिर question का answer निकाल लेंगे. That depends on your mind. Okay, that depends on your practice. Whatever the practice you have done for this exercise 1.1, so same you have to show here. ठीक है, अगर आपने thoroughly इसको revise किया है, then you must remember about the questions which have been asked in this exercise 1.1. आपको सिर्फ questions की detail देनी है हल्की से. You have to tell the relation only. For example, for this, the relation which is symmetric. So you may, for this, you may talk about the perpendicular lines. ठीक है, perpendicular lines. This is L1, first line. Is perpendicular to second line L2, is perpendicular to third line L3. Okay, now which is neither reflexive. Reflexive matlab, if L1 should be perpendicular to L1, is it possible that L1 is perpendicular to L1? Koi line apne aap pe perpendicular ho sakti hai? Not possible. So it means this example is not reflexive, right? So here you can take L1, L2, L1 is perpendicular to L2. So like this, you can make the relation. Okay? So this will be your relation. So at the back, you can check the answer also. You may take another example also if it is there in your mind. Otherwise, in my mind, this example has struck only. Okay. Then nor transitive. Transitive we know. If L1 is perpendicular to L2, L2 is perpendicular to L3, then L1 should be perpendicular to L3. Just see from the diagram. L1 is perpendicular to L2, L2 is perpendicular to L3. Is it possible L1 is perpendicular to L3? No. Definitely, if you know the geometry, then L1 will be parallel to L3. L1 will be parallel to L3. So this will not be transitive. After that, it should be symmetric. Symmetric, how it is? If L1 is perpendicular to L2, then L2 should be perpendicular to L1, and that is sure. If you know the geometry, then you can tell, yes, this can happen here. So like this, you have to find out the example for this type of a relation. Okay. So let us talk about the one more part. Rest are your homework. Let us talk about the fifth part. It should be symmetric again and transitive. It should be transitive also, but not reflexive. So here we can talk about brother. Okay, A comma B, such that A is brother of B. Okay, not reflexive. अब आप देखो, A A का भाई हो सकता है, कोई अपना ही भाई हो सकता है, ठीक है, which is not possible. So it means this is not symmetric. A A do not belongs to the given relation R. Clear? So only this thing you have to mention there. This is your answer. Only I am discussing why we have written this. A A do not belongs to R. उसके बाद it should be symmetric. अगर A B का भाई है, then B A का भाई होगा कि नहीं? ठीक है, simple thing. If A is a brother of B, then B will be brother of A. So this is symmetric. After that, transitive. Transitive के लिए क्या है? If A is brother of B, and further B is brother of C, then it is sure that A will be brother of C. ठीक है, if you take the example of a family in which 3 children are there, ठीक है, brother sister या sister को छोड़ो परे, आप brothers ले लो, 3 brothers are there. अब हैं तो तीनों भाई. अब ये बोलेगा कि मैं इसका भाई हूँ, इसके साथ ज़्यादा प्यार है, ये बोलेगा कि मैं इसका भाई हूँ. तो अगर इनमें प्यार हो चाहे ना हो, लेकिन फिर भी ये भाई होंगे. ठीक है, if A is a brother of B, B is a brother of C, then it means A will be brother of C. This is the nature only. Okay, common sense. There is no mathematics, only common sense is there. Okay, I hope you have understood. Now you must be able to solve thoroughly exercise 1.1. Okay, so complete it as soon as possible so that we can start with our new exercise as well as the new topic, that is functions. Okay, so thanks for watching the video, and I hope you have understood. So you may share the video with your friends also, like the video and subscribe to the channel so that you can get the notification for the new video. Okay, thanks a lot.